Okay, so we have turned on very quickly, and what we are going to be looking at are some reactive elements. An RC filter in this one of these circuits. Reactive elements. Resistance and capacitance. Alright, so we draw now the circuit for the reactive elements. And we have now resistance RIN, diode, plus or minus, V diode. Here we have capacitance of the reactive elements. Same VI equals VI sine omega T. VDC another resistance here called power. It's like a complex impedance. Zero. And we call this now a diode circuit with reactive elements. RC filter. We say now when small signals conditional, it is a simple matter to take into account reactive elements such as the RC filter. Clearly, the capacitors can have no effect on the operating point or peak point, so that the DC calculation is unaltered. Also, the slope of the diode characteristic, 1 over RD, at the Q point does not change. So if you have RD is equal to what? Delta VD over delta ID. And if we invert 1 over RD, transconductance of ID, that will be equal to ID over VD. 1 over RD at the Q point, it does not change. And we can use Ohm's law to calculate the AC current and the diode voltage. So what we have is that I dN equals VI over RI plus R dynamic plus complex equilibrium zero. Where I dN and VIN denotes the peak current and voltages and voltage. And ZL is the complex impedance. This is illustrated below in an example. So we're going to give an example now how to use all these elements, the reactive elements, and with some specific values to some of the parameters RI, VT, RD, and VD. And suppose we said now that a junction diode is used in the circuit, in this circuit, a junction diode, and that the peak current and voltage is up to, and that VDC now, VDC is a circuit. Equals 1.5 V VIF equals 20 millivolts, and RI equals 10 amps, and RI equals 90 ohms, and RL equals 200 ohms. Capacitance C equals 100 microfarad, and omega equals 10 to the 4 radians per second. So we have values now for this circuit with reactive elements. We have a value for almost everything, the R1, T1, RL, VDC, RF, VIM. And we're using the junction value. Okay. Now we wish to find the voltage across RL. We want to find the voltage across RL. Now for the solution, now to find the key point, the DC load line is drawn to this point, and we have a slope is equal to minus 1 over RI plus RL. That's equal to minus 1 over RI 10 ohms plus RL 19 ohms. That's equal to minus 0.0. Well, the intersection of the load line and the diode characteristic occurs at 7.5 milliamps. This is now the graphical evaluation of the equipment. Small signal equivalent circuits. Well, the location of the Q point on the curve and the size of the AC signal indicate a small signal T 2 will be at location Q. And what we have is that I, dynamic resistance equal now to 25 multiplied by 10 to the minus 2 over 7.5 multiplied by 10 to the minus 2. Yeah, the dynamic resistance is 25 millivolts at 200 degrees K when 1 milliamps is flowing through. And it's equal to the delta Vt, which is over Id, a Q point, which is 7.5. And that will be equal now to 3.2. Now this was 7.5 to that. 25, you get 2.2. Well, since the reactant, I'll just take all those values quickly. I want to say, no, since the reactants actual value of epsilon is equal to 1 over omega c negligible impedance. And we have ZL approximately equal to R1 over R1 in parallel with R1. R1 in parallel with R1. And if you know the old people parallel resistance, what it will be take the product, that would be R1 RL over R1 plus RL. So that would be equal to 200 multiplied by 90 over 200 plus 90. That's equal to 0. Do that to get 62 ohms. But we had a 290, but not by itself, but 900, 1800 over 290, which is 180 over 29. You could see this from approximately, the approximate is to be 30, it would be 180 over 30. 26 is 18, if you approximate is 60. But you know that 29 is less than 30, so it's going to be more, so that will be 62. That means VC is equal to 0. This is going to use the value of the dynamic resistance RD and ZL. We get that. The last calculation that we have to do now is the VIN, which is the peak voltage, the amplitude of peak voltage, and that's equal to I dN, the peak current. RD to be 3.3 and 10 is RI given. RI equals 10. We calculate RD to be 25 millivolts over 3.3 for that and over 62. So there you are, now we have some reactive elements in these circuits. The RC filter introduces complex impedance, and we made the calculations given these values. VDC equals 1.5 volts, VIB equals 20 millivolts, RI equals 10 ohms, R1 equals 90 ohms, load current 200 ohms, and capacitance 100 microfarad, and omega 10 to the 4 radians per second.